Hello and welcome to the vlog. After a pleasingly quiet Friday night moored in Beeston, I set off again.
Having come off the Trent at Beeston, which you have to do because the Trent is unnavigable around Beeston and Nottingham, I now go along the Beeston Canal, which becomes the Nottingham Canal, seamlessly. It's all just one body of water, but technically it's two canals. And then the Nottingham Canal emerges on the other side of Nottingham back onto the River Trent. So we'll do that today and go on to the next lock above that.
You may not be able to tell, but the water here was relatively clear for a canal. I could almost see the bottom just a few feet down. You certainly know when you're on an urban canal, though.
One thing you definitely notice when going through a big town or city is that the people on the towpath aren't used to the general notion of saying hello to a passing narrowboater. Anytime in the countryside or a little town or village, it's a cheery wave to anyone walking by or jogging by or dog walking or whatever. Come to a city and it's typical city behaviour. They're all busy in what they're doing, and when you say hello, they look shocked and horrified. Not all of them, obviously, but a noticeable number are not expecting to say hello to the passing boats. It's a shame.
The folk on this boat were quite the opposite, waving and saying hello as I passed. Here's something I rarely see on the canals: stand-up paddleboarding, or kneel-down paddleboarding in this case. Were I to try it, it would be hold on for dear life boarding, followed by splosh and swear word boarding. After that follows the biggest winding hole I've ever seen, practically its own mini lake, presumably because they get them wide beams down here, so they need as much space as possible. And then for a while there's not much to see, until suddenly you spot some moorings. I confess to being away in my own little world in my head as I approach this bridge, which is always guaranteed to mean there's a boat coming the other way. Sure enough, look, the bow of another craft approaching. Time for a bit of reverse thrust. I don't know why I did that though. As just mentioned, this is a wide canal, so there is space for two passing narrowboats.
I'm not quite sure at what point the Beeston Canal becomes the Nottingham Canal, but I'm definitely coming into what I would class as proper Nottingham now, I think.
This boatyard is called Trevithick, and with a name like that, I can't help wondering, given the time that the canals were being built, as to whether there's a connection to Richard Trevithick, the inventor of the first steam engine and steam loco. I googled, but to no avail. Turn a couple of corners more, and a vista of moorings spreads across the horizon. I rather like this and want to peek inside. Apart from all the boats on the canal itself, you'll notice quite a few moored at Castle Marina on the right. I know I just painted my roof, but this grass idea looks fantastic. If the roof was flat, you could have a putting green up there. The visitor moorings here go on for hundreds of yards, and behind those trees there's a big Sainsbury's supermarket, ideal for passing boaters. This warehouse, dating from 1894, is now offices for rent. I came to the only lock within Nottingham. There's a pub on the left where people can sit on the lock side and watch boaters going through. The current global situation put paid to any drinkers there when I passed by, though. That could do with some greasing. I only opened one lock gate, being, frankly, lazy. But the lock had other ideas, and as soon as I brought the boat in, it opened the other gate of its own accord, forcing me to scurry round the other end and back up again to close it. Only then could I start opening the paddles to let the water out. The swirling maelstrom below is always belied by the very genteel descent of the boat. Just days after I passed through here, the Canal and River Trust announced the whole of this canal has received green flag status, which apparently recognises well-managed green spaces. Though, despite reading the press release carefully, it's entirely unclear what this means in practice. Normally this area of pubs and restaurants would be bustling, so it is a bit sad to see it all so quiet. Here it's a straight run through office blocks until you get to a 90 degree right turn at the end. Just before the lock back onto the Trent, there's a services point which I pulled into. And thanks here to the three young lads on the boat on the right there, who leapt out and pulled the back end of my boat in as the wind tried to push it away as I was mooring. I didn't ask them to, they just saw me having an awkward time of it and came to my rescue. With the water tank replenished, I entered Meadow Lane Lock, which is desperately in need of maintenance. There's no paddle gear on the right-hand lower gate, and both the upper paddles were stuck open, filling the lock with water as I tried to empty it. It made opening the bottom gates an absolute nightmare, and I nearly did my back a nasty injury. Back out on the Trent, and that's the home of Nottingham Forest Football Club. There was a huge CRT workboat on the lock landing. Luckily, there's another pontoon around the corner, which this other boater had to use before coming into the lock. If you didn't know it was there, you'd blink and miss it, and I nearly did, but on the right here is the entrance to the Grantham Canal, which is under restoration. I continued under Lady Bay Bridge. There were just a couple of miles to the next river lock, which is where I'd stop. You would be correct in assuming that penthouse apartments there go for around £1 million each. Unlike that indistinct blue thing floating in the river near Sawley, this was clearly a marker buoy used by the sailing club up ahead on the corner of the river. One thing did surprise me on the river. There are distance markers in the guidebook, bizarrely in kilometres, and they have real-life equivalents on giant posts on the bank. It makes it very easy to know where you are. And where I was outside Colwick Marina on the approach to Holme Lock. As usual, there's a mighty weir to avoid, seen on the left here. But a slightly confusing sign suggests boats should veer to the right. But don't veer up there, as that's the start of a whitewater kayak run. Instead, you take the middle channel, and here you spot another confusing sign. That's all very well, but where is the obstruction in the water and how are you supposed to avoid it? It's no good just saying there is one. I later discovered the sign just refers to a bit of a concrete shelf on the moorings, not an obstruction in the water at all. At the time, I played safe and moored in front of the sign, pondering where the danger lurked. This being a river, I had long lines which could let the boat move up and down if the water levels changed. The mop I later knocked overboard and it floated off to the weir, never to be seen again. I'm incredibly annoyed about polluting like that, but I couldn't retrieve it. Oh, and for good measure, I tied a loose rope to the centerline pin of the boat as well. The boat was not going to float off to the weir like the mop did. Here's the charming view from inside. Much better this way, not least because I could watch the cormorants sunning themselves on the buoys. Amazingly, they had a shift system going with the gulls. Every day they'd swap. Cormorants in the morning, gulls in the afternoon. After my exhausting river boating, I needed a cheese sandwich on a chipped plate. Plus, of course, a nice hot cup of tea. No, that spoon does not need cleaning. As usual, the laptop was set to work, copying the day's footage from card to hard disk. And I went off to see the whitewater kayaking site. This was all man-made, opened in 1986, and it's 700 metres long. Apparently, it's been home to the Commonwealth Games and the European Championships. I tell you this, you wouldn't catch me going in there. The sign made me chuckle though. Surely, nobody looks at that water and thinks, I'll just get my speedos on and go for a dip in that. And on that note, cheerio.